Hello everybody, hope you're all well and keeping safe. Welcome back to our third digital guitar lesson. Today we've got a great song for you. It's a great rock song, but first of all, let's tune up our guitars. E string first. And the A string. And the D string. String and the B string and then the last string, the E string. And there we've got elephants and donkeys, grow big ears. Now, the song this week uses our chord E, which we've used loads in the past few weeks. And we're going to use A as well. Now, we've got a new chord as well. We're going to try a chord called F sharp. Now, when you see F sharp wrote down, it looks like F and then a little hashtag after the capital F. So F sharp on the guitar, I'll show you the basic way first. If you're a beginner guitar or a bass guitar player, all you have to do is just play the first string, E for elephant, touching fret at square number 2. That sound, that note is called F sharp. Now, if you're a bit more advanced and you want to give the proper F sharp chord a go, this is where you put the fingers. Finger one goes on the first string, second square, like you would if you were the beginner or the bassist. Your third finger, that is going to go in the fourth fret on the next string. So your finger two does nothing, and you've got a gap between finger one and finger three. Yeah. Your little finger, if you can put that just underneath your third finger there, also on the fourth fret, that there is what you call a power chord or a fifth chord. If you just literally strum those three strings, you get a nice solid sound. And because you are in fret 2 and fret 4 playing that sound, it's called F sharp. And that's the sound you want. If you want it to go all the way, what you got to do with finger one is lie it flat right across all the strings, really pressing in hard against all the strings. Keep those two fingers where they are on fret 4 on the A string and on the D string. And if you strum all 6 strings, that chord is called F sharp minor. You don't necessarily need to know this just yet, but minor means sad, and this is how you play F sharp minor. So there's three options on how we can play this F sharp. Either the beginner version, just playing the one string, second square, or you can play the three finger version. That was just fret 2, fret 4 on the A and fret 4 on the D, just strumming those three strings. That's F sharp, that's the bar chord, the power chord version. Or lie finger one really hard against all of square 2 and press in on the 4s again on the A and the D and strum all 6 strings, and that's the F sharp minor version. So that's our three chords for today. E, F sharp, that, go to F sharp again, whichever version you'd like to do. So today we're going to play a rock song. This is by a chap called Sam Fender. Sam Fender is from Whitley Bay. So he's a local northeast guitarist. He's only about 22 year old, but he's now famous all over the world. He had an album out last year. It went to number one. He plays festivals all over the UK, US, Australia, Japan. He's on TV talk shows all the time. He's a really good guy, and he is now massive. The song is massive as well. The song is called Hypersonic Missiles. I'm going to play the song through. We're going to listen to it first. I'm actually going to show you a clip from his performance at a Glasgow festival. He's got a massive crowd, and it just shows how good he is on the guitar and how good his band are sounding live. Yeah. So we're going to play Hypersonic Missiles live through. As we go through, I shall point out the different sections in the song, the different verses and the choruses, and then we shall discuss the chords, how you play them in the verses and choruses after the clip. So, enjoy. So the song starts straight away with verse one.
Dodge kids hold balloons in the parking lot. The gold arches illuminate the business park. I eat myself to death, feed the corporate machine. I watch the movies, recite every line and scene. God bless America, all over ties. I'm not the first to live with one over my head.
And go straight into verse two. And this is the chorus section. Straight into verse three. This is the solo. This is the bridge. It's the chorus again. And this is the outro, the coda section. And So there we go, local guy, Sam Fender, doing his thing all over the world, and that's one of his biggest hits called Hypersonic Missiles. So this is how you play the chords for Sam Fender Hypersonic Missiles. The verses are quite repetitive. We've got here our E chord. You play E chord 16 times. Remember, there's four beats inside each bar, each box. So we've got four beats, four beats, four beats, four beats, and all those E's add up to 16. The next line, there's those F with the hashtags, F sharps, yeah? You've got four lots of them. So four beats, four beats, four beats, four beats, and there's your 16 F sharps. Now the next line, A, you've got a bar of four and a bar of four. So you've actually got eight A's there on that third line. And back to F sharp, but only for eight beats again. And then the last line is you go back to the E chord again. So when you're strumming these beats, E chord for example, it's 16 E's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That rhythm and that beat is ideal for beginners, so feel free to play throughout the song with that beat. Nice and just straight forward. If you feel you're a more intermediate level player, double all of those strums up all of the time. So you're still playing 16 beats, but strumming wise, you're actually playing 32 strums because you're going to double them all up. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. What you call a quaver rhythm, that quaver rhythm will give the pulse that the song requires. Yeah? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now, if you feel you're more of an advanced player, you can do a very similar technique, but this technique is called palm muting. So you're still going to play quickly the quaver rhythm, but if you get your palm, it's that section there of the hand, and place it between the bridge and the strings, just place it like that, and if you put your E chord back on, don't let go of the palm stays attached to the bridge and strings all the time, and just strum the first few strings of the E chord. Get that sound. Now that's quite a tricky technique to get hold of, so by all means, those advanced guitarists, this could be a technique you feel you want to practice quite a while. You get a real cool sound when it happens though, yeah? Real rhythmic chug sound, yeah? And this is what Sam Fender does at the beginning of Hypersonic Missiles, yeah? So that technique continues over the chords as well, so you can go to the F sharp chord. There's the beginner F sharp chord there. I just play 16 single notes of an F sharp sound. Or you can play a power chord using the first three fingers of the F sharp chord. Or if you want to do the full advanced version, you can get the palm muting technique back on as well. There's a palm mute attached back there. And our F sharp chord. That chugging along. And then we go to A chord. There's the beginner version or the advanced version. Then we go back to F sharp. And then E to finish. So, let's just take the first verse and try that along with the backing track. So it's E chord to start. Dutch kids on balloons in the parking lot. The good night 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. F sharp. Myself to death, feed the corporate machine. I watch some movies, recite every night. And the A. God bless America and 6, 7, 8. F sharp. The first to live with 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to E. Stay on the E. Verse 2. F sharp again. 5, 6, 7, 8. F sharp. 5, 6, 7, 8. finish this section with a big strum. And then that takes us nicely into the chorus section. Now, the chorus section, once again, it's a nice repetitive pattern. This time though, you play A, only four beats, straight to the F sharp chord for four beats, and then E chord for a total of eight beats. Then the next half of the chorus, similar again, except you've swapped the F sharp and the A around. So it's F sharp first this time, for four beats, A for four beats, and then E for eight beats again. So if we play that through, we have A first, F sharp, and then an E for eight beats. Back to F sharp this time. Repeats again, so back to the A, 2, 3, 4, F sharp, and E, back to F sharp, A, and then E as well. So let's try the chorus now along with the backing track. So it's A, first of all, four beats. One, two, three, go! A. F sharp and E for eight. Four, five, six, seven, eight. F sharp, A, and E again. Repeat all again, so A, F sharp, and then E for eight. Back to F sharp, A, and E again. Well done. So if that's a little too quick for you still with the backing track, feel free just to practice on your own without the backing track. Just pause the video and just practice those three chords, A, F sharp and E. Remember, if the F sharp is still a bit tricky, there's the A. F sharp can still just be that one single note. So the first string, second fret, just pluck it and there's your F sharp. And then E chord for eight, yeah. Says back to F sharp, so just pluck that second fret. There's that note there, A chord, and then E chord. Just nice simple rhythm, nice simple chords, and a nice simple F sharp when you get there. Okay? The next section of the song, it's actually just the verse again. So that's 16 E's, 16 F sharps, 8 A's, 8 F sharps, and then 16 E's. After that, we just go back to the chorus again. However, this time there's no words. The chorus is actually a saxophone and a guitar solo. But if you still play the chords underneath, it will fit perfectly. You just repeat this chorus twice, like we just did, okay? So now let's try all of verse 3 and the solo, the guitar and the saxophone solo, okay? This is verse 3, 16 E's. F sharps. Eight A's. Eight F sharps. And 16 E's. And now back to chorus, A, F sharp, E, F sharp, A, and E, A again, F sharp, E, F sharp, A, and we finish on an E. Now this next section is the bridge section. In this part of the song, it's a bit of a crowd favourite. It's where all the crowd sings along. It's just the whoa section, okay? Chord-wise, it's exactly the same as the bridge. So 16 E's, 16 F sharps, 8 A's, 8 F sharps, 16 E's to finish, okay? Now all that remains in the song is the chorus again. So we're going to repeat this chorus section twice, and then we have something called an outro or a coda. This bit is the ending of the song. Okay, that's what coda means, or outro. It's the ending of the song. The outro, it is literally the last half of the chorus. So it's F sharp for four, A for four, E 8 beats. Then you do it again, F sharp, A, E for 8 beats, and you finish the song, F sharp, and then you finish on the A, just a long sounding A chord. So what we're going to do now, we're going to play the final chorus, and then we're going to jump down to the outro, the coda section, okay? This is the last chorus. A. F sharp. E for 8. F sharp. A. E again, guys. Repeat all that again. A. F sharp. A. B. F sharp. A. Repeat. And you repeat it again. A. F sharp. A. E for 8. F sharp. A. E. Now down at the bottom for the outro. Finish. F sharp. A. E for 8. Same again. F sharp. A. E 8 beats. And that's it. That's the different sections of Hypersonic Missiles by Sam Fender. Now feel free, as we have done in the past, to pause the video at any point to practice those individual sections. And when you feel confident, let's play all the way through together from the beginning right to the end. So here we go, all the way through Sam Fender Hypersonic Missiles. So we start on the E chord.
Dodge kids hot balloons in the parking lot. The gold notches illuminate the business park. I eat myself to death, feed the corporate machine. I watch some movies, recite every line I see. God bless America and all of its
allies.
I'm not the first to live with one of
E again. Back to the beginning again, another verse. Again, 16 beats. A again. So there you go. Hope you enjoyed playing Sam Fender Hypersonic Missiles. Feel free to check out more of his songs. Go on YouTube, go on Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, whatever it is you use. Check out more of Sam Fender. He's got some great songs, great guitarist, great voice as well. Now next week, we're going to do another pop song. It's using one of the chords we did from the first lesson, D. And I'm going to introduce G to you next week as well. So it's a song using D and G. And I look forward to seeing you when we use those two chords in our new song next week. So take care, and I'll see you soon. Enjoy.